afternoon, actually. It's about 1:50 here on a Saturday afternoon. And just have a few things here, check back here on our college basketball games. And a couple different subjects. Nothing as far as NFC trash talk exists today. So, sorry to disappoint you if you're looking for NFC East trash talk. We're not talking about that. So, I was hoping to come on here with a victory speech for my Sixers. I didn't get home in time last night to see the game. NBA season pass. I'm kind of glad it didn't because they lost at home to the Charlotte Bobcats. Now, I don't even know where the Charlotte Bobcats are really at. I don't know if they're, but anyhow, they seem to have. Now they're 1-2 against the Bobcats. They had split. They got one more game remaining with them, I think, on April 7th at Charlotte. So they have a chance to split the season, but they have problems with that kind of a team at home. They beat much better teams at home than the Charlotte Bobcats, but anyway, beat the Lakers, beat San Antonio, beat Houston, beat Portland, in Portland. So, maybe they're just a little road weary because they're just starting to come back. I mean, they did win the first game at home after the five-game road trip in which they went 3-2. So I like our chances as far as making it into the playoffs and doing a little damage. I'm not so sure they can go deep in the playoffs. But I do like the play of Thaddeus Young specifically, and I would like to see Lou Williams play a little more. Of course, we know how the rest, D'Alembert and Igualada and also Maurice Spates. I like to see him assert his own. He only had 2 points last night, so normally if you can get 10, 12, 14 points out of him, they're doing pretty good. But the balance of the scoring came from Igualada and Thaddeus Young, and Andre Miller also didn't have a very good game. So that's Andre Miller not having a good game and Spates not having a good game. Kept the game low scoring, and they won. They lost by five. So anyhow, just goes with the territory. Win comes with win, loss comes with a loss. Now then, on to better things. Don't dwell on a loss too long because it's not the end of the season yet. So we look forward to hearing from the Sixers on down the road. Now then, before I get too carried away here, I am a little perturbed. I'm actually a lot perturbed about the situation with the Dallas police officer who pulled over Ryan Moats and his wife while Ryan Moats' wife's mother was at the hospital on her deathbed, and apparently they had been summoned by the physicians to come immediately, and apparently in that haste that Ryan Moats did run one or two red lights. The police officer, really, really overreacted. All he had to done, it would have been called the hospital. They were right in the hospital parking lot. All he had done was called the hospital to see if their story was legit. And, he didn't do that. And they said he just became a complete asshole and detained the very, very patient Ryan Moats and his wife. And I would like to see justice done, and I would like to see Ryan Moats and his wife sue the living hell out of the Dallas police office. Now, I'm sorry, I'm not saying it's because it's Dallas, but he botched the Kennedy investigation. You're notoriously named for that, and I don't know how many times between now and 1963 there's been some kind of mess up, but this, my God, man. I really don't know how what else to say about that. It's just a totally, totally messed up situation. Ryan Moats, who was drafted by Philadelphia and released last year, I'm knowing Steve that I just assumed he was going to stay along for special teams. But anyhow, my condolences to him and his wife for their loss. And as far as the police officer is concerned, you cannot say sorry. I am sorry this happened. Oh, yeah, you're sorry now. Because you know there's a lawsuit getting ready to crawl up your ass. I don't know, man. You just continuously hear about police overreacting and using an unreasonable amount of force. It's really sad. It really and truly is sad. So, again, that's that thing there, and that's just bad. So, I'm leaving it at that. Like I say, my condolences to Ryan Boats and his fiance or his wife on the passing of her mother. So then, what else? College basketball is at halftime. I don't know what game is really on. I just turned it on. Villanova is looking good. Look for them to make a little noise, but I don't look for them to go quietly in the night. North Carolina is one of a heavy favorite now. But Missouri is also going to make some noise before said and done. So, anyway, we have a lot of good teams there that are in there yet and could make down to the Final Four and become the Elite Two. So we'll soon see about that. Now, they weren't going to mention the NFC, so I'm not going to. Not going to go with T.O., not going to go there. Simons, 1974, you know why you bragged about T.O. Well, T.O. is up north now. You can fill out your Buffalo Sabres application and go up there and watch the Buffalo Sabres. At the same time, you can watch the Buffalo Bills. That's all I got to say about that. And I'll have a little something later on T.O., a little later. Around about training camp, maybe. I don't know. Spring training camp or something. Anyhow, I'm just afraid that I sat here and ran it on and ran it on, but I just had to get those two things out.
Walking out on the street, and the wind catches your feet.